Hello everyone, I am Anisha Srivastava and in today's class we will discuss transformation of sentences. What is transformation of sentences? Transformation of sentence is a sentence can be changed. Sentence can be changed from one kind to another without changing its meaning. This is the transformation of sentences. Means a sentence can be changed from one kind to another. We can change sentence in many ways, but we cannot change its meaning. For example, seeing a lion, Mohan ran away. This is a sentence and we can write it in many ways as Mohan saw a lion, he ran away. And one more sentence we can write with it. Mohan saw a lion and ran away. All the sentences are same. Its kind is same, but its meaning is its kind is different, but its meaning is same. This is the transformation of sentence. We can change, we can write sentences in many kinds. We can change a sentence from one kind to another, but we cannot alter its meaning, and this is the transformation of sentence. Now we move to next topic. How can we change a sentence from exclamatory to declarative? I think this is so clear to everyone that what is the transformation of sentences. A sentence can be changed from one kind to another without changing its meaning. We cannot change its meaning. We can write it in different ways. We can write a sentence in different ways, but we cannot change its meaning. And this is the transformation of sentence. Now we will start from how can we convert exclamatory sentence to declarative. I think this everyone knows that what is exclamatory sentence. Exclamation, putting exclamation means exclamatory sentences which contains surprises or emotion. Surprises or emotions like ah, hurrah, wow, and we have to put the exclamation mark also. This is the sign of the exclamation. This. And what is declaration? Declarative. Declarative sentence make a statement. For example, with the help of the example, we will discuss it. She is a brilliant, active. This is a sentence. And we have to change it into exclamatory. How can we write it? What a brilliant actress we can do. What a brilliant actress she is. And put the sign. This is a statement, this is a sentence, and we have to be converting into exclamatory. Now, an exclamatory sentence can be changed into declarative. Not only this, we can change declarative sentence into exclamatory also, like this. As what a brilliant actress she is, this is the exclamatory. And when we have to convert it into declarative, how can we write? We can write like, she is a brilliant actress. One more example. How beautiful she is. This is an exclamatory sentence, and we have to convert it into declarative. How can we convert it? She is very beautiful. So, means exclamatory sentence can be changed into declarative, and declarative sentences can be changed into exclamatory. I think it is clear. I'll give one more example so that it will be a move. What? Simple sentence we will take. Gold is very precious. Okay, this is a declarative sentence, and we have to convert it into exclamatory. How can we convert it? Gold is very precious. How precious? How precious gold is. Is it clear? I think it is clear to everyone. We will move to next topic, that is from declarative to interrogative. Again the same thing, that not only we can change declarative into interrogative, we can do the vice versa, means declarative to interrogative and interrogative to declarative. But we have to remember one thing in declarative sentence, that when we change declarative sentences into interrogative, we put verb before the subject. We put, this is the main thing. You must remember it, that before the subject, we use verb while changing the declarative sentences into interrogative sentences. For example, with the help of the example, it will be more clear to you all. Example. John has come to visit. John has come to visit. Okay. Now we have to convert it into interrogative. What I told you earlier, that we have to use verb before subject. So what is the verb here? What is this? So we will write has, and what is the subject here? John has John come to visit? This is the interrogative sentence. This is how we convert declarative into interrogative. Take one more example. This is Naresh's wallet. This is a simple sentence. How can we convert it into interrogative? What is the verb here? Is, then this Naresh's wallet. Put question mark. You know now that the interrogative sentence contains a direct question. Declaration contains a statement, declarative sentence contains a statement, and interrogative contains a direct question. So, and one main thing you must remember that while changing the declarative sentence into interrogative, you must use verb before the subject. If you remember this thing, these sentences will never be wrong. Clear? We can take one more example. She is very kind. This is a simple sentence, and we must remember that we don't have to change the meaning of the sentence. So what we will write when we will convert into interrogative, we sentence kind should be changed, but we cannot alter its meaning. So how can we write? Is she very kind? No, she is very kind. This we know. Isn't, we will ask the question, isn't she very kind? In order not to change the meaning, we use isn't, aren't, hasn't, haven't, aren't, like this. Take another example. I am in class 5. How can we convert it into interrogative? Am not, am in. I in class 5. These are the ways through which we can change declarative into interrogative sentences. Is that clear to everyone? I think it is clear to everyone. And one more thing, that when a declarative sentence contains the adverb never, when declarative sentences contains the adverb never, so it becomes, never becomes ever while changing it into interrogative. For example, I never asked you to do it. This is a declarative sentence, and we have to convert it into interrogative. So, in place of never, what I told you, that in place of never, we used ever while converting it into interrogative. It is in past tense asked, to be used did. Did I ever, in place of never, what we are using? We use ever. Did I ever ask? Did I ever ask you to do it? I never asked you to do it. This is the declarative. And did I ever ask you to do it? And this is the interrogative. This is how we change declarative sentence into interrogative. Few more examples we will do related to this topic. From imperative to interrogative. What do you mean by imperative sentence? Imperative, which gives us command or order, we can say. From imperative sentence to interrogative. Interrogative, so I told you earlier that interrogative is a interrogative contains a direct question. And imperative gives a command or order. For example, and the same thing follows with this also, that we can convert imperative to interrogative and vice versa. Means interrogative to imperative, imperative to interrogative. For example, stop talking. This is in order. Stop talking. And we have to convert it into interrogative. How can we convert it? Will you stop talking? Stop talking. This is a command giving to anyone that stop talking. So when we convert imperative, this sentence into interrogative, how can we convert? Will you stop talking? But we can make it more polite. We can use, how can we make it in a polite manner? Like, will you please stop talking? When your children continuously talking, then what the teacher said, what we used to say, that children, please stop talking. Will you please stop talking? Like that only, the same thing in a polite manner. We can make it in a polite manner. This sentence is also correct and both both the sentences are correct. Stop talking. Will you stop talking? And in a polite manner, we use will you please stop talking. We will do some other example related to this. Shut the door. How can we write? Yes, as simple, it is simple. Will you shut the door? Or in a polite manner, will you please shut the door? I think this looks nice, you know? Will you please shut the door? This is not an order. Will you please, I'm requesting if it's okay. Shut the door. Will you shut the door? Will you please shut the door? Some more, few more examples. Come here. Now how can we convert it into interrogative? Will you please come here? Correct? Or will you come here? Or clear, children? Now we will do some sentences related to the topics which I told you earlier in this class. Change the sentences. Change the sentences as instructed. First is, it is a great victory. Change into interrogative. We have to convert it into interrogative. How can we convert it? Isn't it a great victory? Question is, isn't it a great victory? Yes, it is a great victory. Now, second, do not disturb me. We have to convert it into interrogative. How can we convert it? Do not disturb me. Will you please stop disturbing me? Clear? Next sentences. What a beautiful view. What a beautiful view. We have to convert this sentence into declarative. Means we have to make a statement. How can we convert it? It is a beautiful view. I think it is clear to everyone. These topics that first we discussed exclamatory to declarative, declarative to interrogative, then imperative to interrogative. Then we have done few examples. With this, I think it is, these topics are clear to everyone. We will move to another topic, that is from affirmative to negative. What do you mean by affirmative sentences? Affirmative sentences that affirms a preposition. We can change affirmative sentences into negative. From, with the example, with the help of the example, we will clear our doubts. From affirmative to negative. So, an affirmative sentence can be changed into negative with a change in its meaning. For example, when we convert affirmative sentence into negative, it will show that when we put not in any sentence, the meaning should be changed. For example, my sister lives in Goa. This is affirmative sentence, right? This is affirmative, and we have to convert it into negative. So how can we can convert it? If I'll say that student, my sister lives in Goa. This is an affirmative. This is an affirmative sentence, and you should convert into. You have to convert it into negative. How can you convert it? My sister does not live in Goa. This is a negative sentence, right? When we convert affirmative into negative, we have to use not, na? In a negative form, we have to convert it. So, my sister lives in Goa. How can we write in a negative sentence? We can write, my sister does not live in Goa. Take some other example. I have many friends. This is affirmative. So when we have to convert it into negative, how can we change it? I have no friends. In place of many, what we will use? We will use no, because we have to convert it into negative. We are converting it into negative. So what we will use? I have many friends. Well, in place of many, we will use no. I have no friends. Full stop over there. Clear? Now one more thing. In an affirmative sentence, an affirmative sentence can be changed into negative without changing its meaning also. How? Interchange of affirmative. Let me clear. Remember this rule, children, that if we change affirmative sentence into negative without changing its meaning, how can we change it? This is, remember one rule, that when interchanging affirmative into negative sentences by using not, before opposite words. For example, let me clear. Take one example. This girl is intelligent. This girl is intelligent. How can we change this affirmative sentence into negative without changing its meaning? I told you that while using not before, when we convert affirmative into negative without changing its meaning, we put not, and then after not, what we will write? The opposite word of that. This girl is intelligent. How can we convert it? This girl is not. Girl is intelligent. So what is the opposite of intelligent? It is dumb. This girl is not dumb. Clear? So this, the girl is intelligent and the girl is not dumb. Meaning is same. Meaning is same. Sentence is in negative. Okay. The girl is intelligent. How can we convert it into negative? The girl is not dumb. By putting not before the opposite word. Intelligent, what is the opposite of intelligent? It is dull. And before dull, what I have written? Not. This is a negative, and we put opposite of that word, not dull. This makes the sentence, this makes the meaning of the sentence as it is. Take one more example. If it is not clear, she is a beautiful girl. How can we convert it into negative without changing its meaning? What I said, that she is, what we put? Not. And what is the opposite of beautiful? Ugly. Before ugly, what we will use? And. She is not an ugly girl. Time is changed, but meaning is same. Is it clear to everyone? Now, today's last topic is tag questions. What are tag questions? I think these topics are clear to everyone. Now, we move to another topic, that is tag question. What do you mean by tag question? Tag questions are added to the onto the end of the declarative sentence. When we use tag questions at the end of the declarative sentences, these questions usually ask for confirmation, or we can say that short questions. That, for example, I am a student, right? I am a student. So this is a positive sentence. One more thing you should remember, that with a positive sentence we use negative tag, and with negative sentence we use positive tag. This is a positive sentence, so what we use? We use negative tag. What is the verb here? I am a student. I am a tag. This is positive. Positive sentence we use, with positive sentence we use negative tag. Negative tag. She is a student. One more example. She is a student. This is a positive sentence. So we use negative tag. How? What is the verb here? Is. Isn't she? Clear? This is very simple thing, children. You will do the practice and you will easily know how to do it. Now take few more example about negative sentence with positive tag. He was happy. Sorry, negative sentence. He wasn't happy. He wasn't happy. This is a negative sentence. This is a negative sentence. And with this, with the negative, what we will use? Positive tag. What is the verb here? Was. Was he. Clear? He wasn't happy. Negative sentence with positive tag. Clear? One more example. He hadn't gone home early. This is a negative sentence. So with the negative sentence we use positive tag. What we will write? What is the verb here? Have. So had. Remember it. With the intact questions, if positive sentences are there, we use negative tag, and with negative sentences we use positive tag. So children, what we discuss in today's class? Transformation of sentences. First of all, what we discuss, that what is the transformation of sentences? Transformation means we can change the sentence, but we can change the sentence from one kind to another, but we cannot change its meaning. Then we discuss exclamatory to declarative, then declarative to exclamatory. Means we can change exclamatory sentences into declarative sentences and vice versa. Then declarative to interrogative. After that, what we discuss? We discuss imperative to interrogative, then affirmative to negative. Then at last, we discuss tag questions. So children, with this, I'm going to end my class. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you. Good day.